airport security. Turkey actually has offered to assure its security. But it was supposed to NATO forces to withdraw Afghanistan. Turkey is also a NATO forces. So what do you think about that, first of all? I want to start from here.
Well, going by the peace agreement that Afghan Taliban had with Americans and the NATO, all the NATO troops, no matter they belong to Turkey, United States, or somebody else, they are bound to leave. They were supposed to leave, in fact, by May 1st this year, but it was extended by the USA on its own by September 11. My understanding is they are going to leave Afghanistan long before September 11. Now there is a bigger picture, and the bigger picture is that since Turkey cannot stay in Afghanistan under the NATO umbrella, Turkey will have to have at least two agreements. One with the Western-backed government in Kabul, the Ashraf Ghani government. The other agreement, it will have to have a bilateral agreement or maybe a multilateral agreement with the Turkey and the other countries like Pakistan and the Hungary that Turkey is interested to go along with. However, the Taliban's have straight away refused. So far, all the information that we have in this part of the world that suggests that the Afghan Taliban's are not instead interested in anybody's presence in Afghanistan. And they, so far, they have refused to do so. Now, technically speaking, the Ashraf Ghani government, which has been backed by the West, it can enter into an agreement with the Turkey and other multilateral governments. But if Taliban's are not willing to accept Turkey and all other countries, then there would be certainly a problem. But Turkey is hoping that since it has a goodwill among the Muslim countries, and during last two decades, Taliban, I think there was just one incident where Taliban attacked Turkish forces, which had its humanitarian role in Afghanistan. They never had a combat role. So Turkey is expecting that the Taliban would have a softer approach. And Turkey is, in fact, depending on to Pakistan, that since Pakistan enjoys good terms with the Taliban, and Pakistan would use its leverage to convince Taliban to allow Turkish troops have security positions in and around the Hamid Karzai International Airport in near Kabul. So I think it is still something which is easier said than done. As President Tayyip Erdogan himself realized that the Taliban are the reality in Afghanistan. They are controlling 75% territory. And during just last few weeks, when Americans started withdrawing, which means from May 1st onwards, Taliban have captured 30 districts. They are fast inching towards capital Kabul, and they have already taken over the key strategic districts through which they can penetrate into the Kabul city. So there is already an alarm bell, which means that this airport is extremely important. This is extremely important in the sense that all the Western diplomats, there is a possibility that they may have to run away from Kabul, because if the Taliban go for some sort of a violent takeover of the capital city, as it had already happened back in early 90s, when after the Soviet withdrawal, then those Mujahideen had taken over the Kabul capital by use of force. So that possibility somehow or the other looms large. And in that context, I think if the Turkish forces control Kabul airport, that means it will facilitate the Western diplomats to leave Afghanistan. Because in a crisis-like situation, that airport is going to play a very important role. I'm saying this because of the fact that so far we have not heard any progress in ongoing negotiations between Afghan Taliban and Western-backed government in Kabul. There is a little possibility that there would be any progress because Ashraf Ghani government, they are insisting to go for general elections, or he doesn't want to basically leave the power. And Afghan Taliban are insisting to have its dominant role, and they are dictating their terms. And they have their own reasons to say that since they have defeated the NATO and they have exhausted them out during last 20 years. So for them, taking over Kabul is not a big target. I think I see a very, very very gloomy picture, very bleak picture for the Ashraf Ghani government in weeks and months to come. And once Americans leave Afghanistan, probably maybe by July 4th of this year, or maybe later than that, then I think Taliban would accelerate their attacks on Afghan national security forces. They are already deserting to Afghan Taliban. And in that context, Turkey is looking for a role to control and have some sort of security positions on Hamid Karzai International Airport near Kabul. I think it is, again, something easier said than done. Turkey will have to deal more with Afghan Taliban and less with the Ashraf Ghani government, though it has international legitimacy, but it doesn't have a control on Afghanistan. It is largely limited to highways in Afghanistan and the Kabul city. So let's see how things unfold, but I think Turkey will have to deal with Afghan Taliban. That's a bigger challenge.
Thank you, Mr. Rana. I have another question. The National Security Advisor of the United States, Jake Sullivan, said today that Biden and Erdogan, President Erdogan, they agreed on Turkish role, yani Turkish Turkey to play a leading role in Afghanistan, Hamid Karzai Airport. So I want to ask again, do you think that Turkey can maintain good relations with Taliban under the umbrella of NATO?
Well, certainly not under the umbrella of NATO. Under the umbrella of NATO, Turkey is bound to leave Afghanistan along with the NATO forces, because that's a part and parcel of the peace agreement that Afghan Taliban had with the NATO back in February 2019. So now there is a new situation that Turkish forces want to stay in Afghanistan, and they want to confine its role only to the international airport. Partly Turkey needs money from the USA, partly Turkey wants to have its clout on Afghanistan, for the reason that, historically speaking, that Turkey has historical links with the Central Asian states and Afghanistan. Turkey had more strong relations with the Northern Alliance, certain ethnic groups in the past. Now the Northern Alliance is no more there practically. It has been weakened to a point where it cannot resist Afghan Taliban. So Turkey will have to deal with the Afghan Taliban. And remember, when there were negotiations between Americans and Afghan Taliban, Americans insisted to have their troops inside Afghanistan. They wanted to just maintain one or two air bases there. And Taliban said this is something next to impossible. They don't want foreign boots on their land. And Americans had to agree on that, and they said they are very tough negotiators. So now expecting that the Taliban would allow foreign forces on its soil is again something easier said than done. But again, Turkey at this particular point of time is using Pakistan's leverage, since Pakistan enjoys good terms with the Taliban. Let's see how things unfold. But so far, Taliban have refused to do so. Turkey can enter into an agreement with the Ashraf Ghani government in Kabul. But again, if that government is overthrown in near future, then what would be the status of the Turkish troops guarding the airport? So at the end of the day, I think I would say that Turkey will have to have two agreements in Afghanistan, one with the Ashraf Ghani government, which would give them an international legitimacy, and other, pragmatically speaking, they will have to have a bilateral agreement or a multilateral agreement, given Pakistan and Hungary's role, with the Afghan Taliban. I don't see that happening. Turkey, I mean, I would say Taliban may put up with the Turkey because it is a Muslim country. It has a good reputation among the Muslim countries that it stands for the Muslim causes. But at the same time, Taliban have a history not to put up with any foreign troops. Let's see how things unfold. Turkey is struggling hard through Pakistan to agree.
At this point, Mr. Rana, why do you think Turkey is struggling so hard to take such a role in Afghanistan?
I think partly it is because of the fact that the Turkey wants to repair its relation with the United States. There has been a lot of controversy and bitter arguments between Ankara and Washington on S-400. And I think Turkey is trying to seek certain concessions from the USA by having its presence in Afghanistan, where Taliban's simply have expelled American troops from Afghanistan through an agreement. So in that context, when Americans badly need to have some sort of presence in Afghanistan, if not directly, maybe through Turkey, Turkey is trying to play very actively and very intelligently to make itself relevant to the overall international situation. Now, there is a kind of a crisis that the Americans are facing. Pakistan has refused to provide them military bases because in case they want to conduct a counterterrorism operation against militants in Afghanistan after leaving Afghanistan. And in that context, they are not getting any air bases from the Central Asian states because Russia has put a lot of pressure on the Central Asian states not to provide Americans any military base. And Pakistan has already refused them. Now, if Turkey is coming in between, they are having its troops on Afghan soil, that is something big. And if that happens, I think that would be a big political victory for the Turkey because it would be able to settle its political scores with Americans in the sense that it can get lot many concessions from the Americans on S-400. And then apart from that, Biden administration has been against President Tayyip Erdogan right in the beginning during the election campaign. He had said that they are going to support opposition in the Turkey against the President Tayyip Erdogan. I think by having a new role in Afghanistan in form of Turkish troops guarding airport, Turkey would be more relevant in improving its bilateral relations with the USA and striking a balance between Russia and the USA, because these big powers are now having a sort of cold war, and then in between China. So in that context, I think Turkey would be relevant to Russia, would be relevant to China, would be relevant to the USA, because China and Russia, they have a lot of influence in Afghanistan, and they want to maintain that influence. They don't want Americans' presence in Afghanistan, and they successfully, I think, supported Taliban's behind the scene. China supported Taliban through Pakistan, and Russia had provided Taliban's weapons. So I think if Turkish troops are there, Turkey would be playing a big geostrategic game to make itself relevant to not only to the Afghan Taliban, but also to the big powers like Russia, China, and the USA, but at the same time creating an impression that it enjoys a goodwill among Muslim countries. So let's see how things unfold. But again, that is it's still something which is on the paper. We don't know how things are going to unfold. So far, Taliban are not willing to accept any foreign troops on its land.
Thank you very much, Mr. Rana. I'm so glad to interview you, and that was a great interview, really. New information for us. And I realized that you are following the updates from Middle East region as well. Mashallah.
The growing tide of anti-Israel sentiments. What you see behind me is just tip of the iceberg of what is happening in the country. More than half of $52 billion black CIA budget is spent on espionage network in Pakistan. How would you handle it?
The US has looked upon Pakistan as an ally at one point, and then as an enemy at the same time.
That is going to be the first legal reason on the basis of which he is going to be instantly ousted by the Supreme Court of Pakistan.
Joining us live, Javed Rana, who's an expert on politics and geostrategic issues.
In the world politics, which is not being driven by any moral principle, it is being driven by the hard geostrategic realities. In a broader picture, more countries would aspire to have nuclear weapons.